Before we dive into talking about applications of noise reduction and mastering and how to use this set of tools that are rolled up into Izotope RX, I thought it would be interesting to spend a moment and talk a little bit about something called Fast Fourier Transform. It's a series of equations that was invented in the year 1805 by a guy named Fourier. Surprise, surprise. And what the Fourier transform allows us to do is take a bunch of information and derive frequency information from individual data points. Now, of course, we didn't have data points back in 1805, but we do now. And so when you take a look at a waveform, if you zoom way, 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 way in, you can take a look at the individual samples that make up a digital word. This is a recording that's made at 48 kilohertz, so there are 48,000 individual values every second to describe this audio. Each is an amplitude point, but it has no indication of frequency. And the only way you can understand anything about frequency is by measuring the activity, the oscillation, the repeated period of a waveform over time. And so in order to see frequency, as it were, you would have to average a whole bunch of individual samples. Now, in a waveform, we can't see anything about frequency. But if we move over to a display like this, I'm going to zoom out just a little bit further, we can begin to see the energy according to the frequency that comprises, or the frequencies that comprise a recording. So we're going to spend a little time looking at the RX interface and understanding how to read this. But one of the important takeaways about understanding using Fast Fourier Transform is the fact that because it is not a sample-specific kind of way of understanding audio, it cannot be sample-accurate. When we think about using limiters or doing other kinds of signal processing that change peak level, as a Fast Fourier Transform kind of process, we will end up with new peaks that are somewhat unpredictable compared to the original recording. This doesn't just apply to noise reduction, it also applies to anything that leverages Fast Fourier Transform to do the work. For instance, deriving lossy files from lossless files, like MP3 or AAC files or OGG files. So there's a couple of different ways of evaluating audio. There is audio that uses the samples themselves to indicate amplitude, and then there are displays that allow us to see the frequency components that are contained within the samples themselves.